Feeling lost in the crowd? Your portfolio can make you stand out. In this video, we'll explore Notion's latest updates, including Notion sites, forms, charts, and page layout features. We'll use these to create an impressive portfolio website. We'll show you how to create a skill line chart using Notion charts. Design an engaging portfolio website with the new page layout feature. Build a contact form that you can embed in your portfolio to collect client information. And publish your Notion docs with SEO optimization and custom branding using Notion sites. Think of this video as a simple workshop. You can get the workshop template for free in the video description. After getting the template, you'll see a pre-designed layout. We'll use this as our starting point. Let's quickly go through the template's basic features. At the top, you'll find the About Me section. Here, you can add your profile picture and introduction. Below that is a Contact Us button that opens the contact form, which we'll learn to create later. Next is your skills showcase to help clients understand your strengths. Categories include software, expertise, and languages. There's also a full list view to see everything at once. To make your portfolio more compelling, we've added number metrics and authority brand sections. Users love seeing numbers and credibility indicators right when they open your portfolio. Below that is a testimonial section. Each testimonial includes the person's name, job title, company, message, and star rating. This is a bonus section not included in the workshop template. I'll show you how to get this bonus section at the end of the video. In the hidden properties, you can select the rating and the star display will update automatically. Further down, you'll find your achievements section. Here you can add competition names, awards, and badges. In the project section, you can include project names, years, and clients. You can also add descriptions and related URLs if needed. The blog section shows article titles, authors, last update times, and estimated reading times. Click the subscribe to our newsletter button below, and a subscription form will pop up. This subscription form currently uses my link, but you can embed your own at any time. The View More button directs you to the blog page. Clicking on an article displays its basic information using Notion's page layout feature, which we will discuss in detail later. Back on the homepage, we've designed a footer like any professional website. Now, let's start with Notion's page layout feature. Click on any skill, then click Customize Layout at the top. In the layout settings, click Add to Panel. You can choose any database property to display in your panel. We'll use the proficiency rating property here. When it appears in the side panel, click the three-dot icon and select Move to Page. To keep the main page uncluttered, relocate the property group to the panel. Click the top module to pin important properties. In this case, we'll pin levels and type. Click Apply to All Pages when done. To enhance your portfolio's uniqueness, let's create a line chart that provides a more visual overview of your skills. Right-click any tab and select Duplicate. Under Layout Options, choose Chart and click Edit Chart. From the chart types, select Horizontal Line Chart. For axis configuration, set proficiency rating as the x-axis and skills as the y-axis. Customize your chart's appearance in the Style section. Next, we'll explore the exciting Notion Form feature. When your clients click the Contact Us button, a pop-up will appear displaying a contact form. Let's go back to the Workshop Templates landing page. Go to the Database page and use the Inline Database command to create a database called Contact Form. Next, create the necessary properties for the contact form, including client's name, company name, email, contact number, and client's message. To generate a form based on your database, click the plus icon in the tab section and select Form. Notion will automatically create the form for you. In this form builder, you can set the title and description of the form and change the order of the questions by dragging the modules. Click the top right corner of the module to designate this question as required or to switch to a long answer format. If needed, you can also add a description to the question. To customize the form submit button and the message shown to users after submission, click the three-dot icon in the upper right corner of the form and select Customize Form. Finally, we need to adjust the permissions for this form so that users who are not in your workspace can also submit this form. With these steps, we've created a basic form. Now, let's return to the homepage to configure the Contact Us button. Click New Action, then select Open Page or URL. Search for our form's title in the subsequent menu. By doing this, we've successfully embedded our Notion form into our portfolio website. If you want your contact form to have more advanced features, you can also try using the free Tally form as your contact form solution. Tally form offers advanced features such as conditional logic, allowing you to create forms that work for both B2C and B2B clients. I'll share the Tally form template for free in the video description. After copying the template, go to the Share tab, select Embed form, and copy the embed link. Replace the original form in your homepage footer's contact page with your Tally form. To highlight the differences, let's create a new contact button for the Tally form. Follow the same process. Select Open Page and search for the Contact Us page. And this will give us a contact button for both the Notion form and the Tally form. The most exciting thing is that all submissions from Tally form can be integrated into a Notion database. To synchronize submissions from Tally form with a Notion database, navigate to the Integrations tab within Form. Select the option to link your Notion account and follow the provided steps. Once completed, your Tally form submissions will automatically sync with the designated Notion database. You may notice Tally's branding on your form. To remove this and access advanced features such as email notifications for respondents, custom domain, and custom CSS, consider upgrading to Tally's Pro plan. With the Pro plan, you can even create a 0% fee checkout form, enhancing your ability to collect payments without additional costs. Finally, let's publish your website. First, go to the Settings tab of your account and find the Sites option. If you haven't changed your website's link, you can customize your subdomain here to make it more branded. If you're a paid Notion user, you've got some cool options for adding a new domain. You can either go with Notion's domain, which is pretty straightforward, or if you want to get fancy, you can shell out $96 a year for your very own custom domain. If you're subscribed monthly, you can purchase the custom domain for just 1 month at a time. It's a nice option for those who want to test it out or need it for a short-term project. All right, once you've got your web address sorted, head back to the homepage. Find the Share button at the upper right corner of the homepage and make this Notion page public on the web. And don't forget to turn on the search engine indexing. That's how you let search engines know you exist. For more advanced website customization, you'll need Notion Plus subscriptions. This lets you customize your site's theme and favicon. In the header section, you have several customization options. We definitely don't want our users to duplicate our entire website, and also enable search if you have lots of blog posts. If you don't want to show Notion's branding, you'll need to purchase the custom domain mentioned earlier. Finally, we can add some important pages to our header so users can quickly navigate to specific sections. Back to the settings panel, we can also add the Google Analytics measurement ID to track user behavior on your website. Once you're done, click Publish Changes, and we've successfully created an appealing portfolio website using Notion. I hope you found this video helpful and are excited about building your portfolio website. Click the link below for the workshop template and follow the tutorial to create an impressive portfolio. If you'd like to support my tutorial video or want a ready-made solution, you can get the complete portfolio template that includes Notion form, chart, and page layout features, along with a bonus testimonial section. Thank you, and best of luck with your professional journey.